Welcome back to Minecraft Atlantis. I'm Marcus, I'm playing for Ariana Gaming. We are going to have some instructions on mobs. So we will craft some different light sources. I'll do all of them like that. So basically in Minecraft, all light blocks, I think, I'm pretty much sure of it, have a light level of 15. So that means that if this is 15 at this point right here, this block would have 14. This block would have 13. This block would have 12. This block would have 11. And if I count 11 and go up again, up to 15, so 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So I'm gonna replace that with a light source that is 15. So if you look here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 blocks. So 7 blocks between, and on the 8 you place a block or a torch. Now the torch is different, it has a light level of 14. So this light level is 14. This would be 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, oi, we will count up, so 11, 12, 13, 14, so at, let's see if I can remove these, like so, okay, so we will have light level of 14 here, we would have a light level of 10 here. If you look, because when you place torches on the ground like this, so if I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, you're gonna miss. You're gonna get careless. I think that might be 8, and that is 8. You know? You're gonna start to make errors. So all of a sudden, a mob will spawn somewhere where you are. But if you place everything, so these are even, I mean, these have a light level of 15, so if you are in a dark place, like underground, or in a cave system or something like that in Minecraft, you want to bring torches. You want to bring a crafting table. If you have that in your inventory, and possibly a bucket of milk, because there are witches down there and they throw potions at you, and if you are hit by one of these potions, if you drink milk, you'll survive. Simple as that. And lots of food, of course, and iron. Pickaxe, because you cannot harvest all the things with the stone pickaxe, so an iron pickaxe is also recommended. So what I thought we would do now, when it comes to day, is actually to find some diamonds. So I took a copy of this survival world, and I went over to creative, and I was flying around, basically just searching for diamonds, and I found them pretty much directly. But there was a problem. I actually crashed my recording device, so after a while I realized, oh, I did crash that. Everything is gone. So that's why I'm doing this smaller tutorial now about how to find diamonds, because we're gonna need a diamond pickaxe for this. Let's see. We are in the right place, I think, but I have already removed I have already removed the lava here. So we had lava. But basically down here at this location we have diamonds at 23 X 126 and said 23. So if you dig down here, there they are. I don't know how many they are, but they are enough. So you just mine these and you will have diamonds. Now, let's see where we can get up. So, because my recording device stopped working, I now have a pickaxe. I've already crafted one. So, I was so happy when I found the diamonds that I got a little bit too excited, maybe, and the recording device stopped working. And I lost all the recordings. So that was kind of a very bad thing, I think. So going over to creative, just banging away at the blocks, you will find diamonds quite easily. Diamonds are available from, I think it's level 16, but you really want to get down to Y, let's see now, Y14. If you get further down than Y14, you will of course have problems with the lava that is down there. So if we go down, let's see down here. I made a staircase down. It starts off at the coordinate. So the first step down is 1x118 and Z20. So did I throw away my map? Okay, so I made a staircase down here. And at the end of this staircase, I also found diamonds. That's where I found my diamonds, which I made at that's where I find my pickaxe. So I don't remember now, but I think it's this way. Yeah, here. Right down here, you can also find diamonds. That's 153 and 7. 153 on the x-axis, and on the z-axis, you should have 7. So, what's that? A spider. Okay, so that said, you have two places where it's safe to mine diamonds. Of course, this is not a place. Of course, there are other places here. So you will have water here. I removed that water. Or maybe you don't. I'm not sure because I was mining above that. But if you make a hole in this wall at 169 y12 and z2. If you just punch a hole in the wall here, 3 blocks deep, you will find this one. So if you place a water bucket, say somewhere on this wall, you will find diamonds here, and you can just stand here. You cannot mine anything with your iron pickaxe if there is water, if there are bubbles. If you are underwater like this, you cannot mine anything. So it takes time to mine diamonds, and it takes even longer time to mine obsidian, which we are actually gonna do now. So right in front of me, I have obsidian. I have 3 blocks here. So you stand in a water stream like this. Not only will the block come to you, but any lava under the block will also be turned into obsidian. So you can just stand here and mine away until you have. You can mine all this lava because you will have. You have 6 more diamonds there, so you can mine away here for a long time. The more obsidian you have, the better it is. So I'm gonna mine about 30, half a stack, 32 blocks, I think. And I have almost finished the iron golem farm up there. There is a few things I want to show you, so I'll stop this. I'll get my water there, like so, and I pick up all the obsidian. So in this very s fast, I got 6. Let's actually, why stop? For the smallest nether portal, you need, let's see, it's 2 wide and 3 blocks high, so that's 6 blocks, and you have to have 2 blocks on top and 2 blocks below. So we are up then to how many blocks? 10. So you need a minimum for to make another portal. You need a minimum of 10 blocks. So I'm gonna mine 10 blocks and then go. Actually, you need 14 blocks, but you can cheat a little bit by putting cobblestone or some other block at the side. Let's see if we can find our way back. Yeah, up here we have a torch, and we have you. I see you. Okay, so those three locations are for diamonds. I found them all by where is out? Where is out? I'm just wanna leave. Please let me leave. Oh, you. I have no food. So when you go down to the, to a cave like that is not lit, it is that has no torches or any light at all. It's like going inside a mob box. We're gonna build a mob farm later on, and it will be so many monsters down there, mobs everywhere. And when you go down into a cave, you are not prepared for it. So this is all the things I've been mined. All these are stone pickaxes. I don't use stone later in the game, but in the beginning here, I've been taking away blocks by hand. All the sand I've removed by hand, and all the other blocks I've been mining with stone pickaxes, and it hasn't been that bad. It sounds really bad, but it has been okay, I think. I mean, I've dug out so much, and it has been really fun. We're gonna have a look. I'm just gonna show you how to remove this sand because this is a trick to it. So if these are gr this is gravel, so this is also behaving. It's behaving like sand. So if I mine this and I quickly put a torch underneath, that was too early. That was exactly incorrect. So all the sand and gravel will fall down on the torch. But you have to time it perfectly for it to work. So if you're really bad at that, you can't get it to work, just take out the block underneath, put a torch, and then punch out the block that is above. Like so. Okay, so then you can easily remove the torch. Let's see if I can find myself a way out. So underneath, this is a cave, so it should be full of mobs down here, but it's quiet. I don't know why, but the way you prevent it is to place torches, okay? So I'm gonna show you the last part here. By placing all this sand, you will be removing the water that is here. So removing the water is absolutely necessary. Now, when I made these measurements for this farm, I didn't realize how much work we got that is put in to actually remove the water and remove all the blocks. Now, for me, because there are so many new blocks, it was fun. I liked it. But it takes a lot of time. I have been going at this for a long time. Like, what should I say? 12 hours maybe? So these are the blocks I got. So if you mine all the diamonds, you should have about 13. And I also made in the video, which you cannot see because it's deleted basically. I also made this block. This is a hopper block. Now, why did I make that? I wanted to do a daylight sensor because the daylight sensor actually activates every night. So how to build that is quite easy. You go over to this. So to survive good, you need three dogs. Without the three dogs, you are m problem constantly. So you need five iron and a chest. And poof, you got hoppers, and hoppers are great. They can transport items. So if I want to transport items, if I want to transport items to say, well, this is good. Did all my dogs just die? No, I have three dogs. So my inventory is totally full. So we have to do something about that. This is the clay I got, the orange stained clay. Let's see. so. This is the cobblestone I got. And I also removed the island we have out here before. We have the mushroom island over there with the mushroom cow, and over there it was an island. It was 2 blocks high, like no higher than this. So I basically removed that island and I got almost a full inventory of blocks and sand, because we want sand to make glass. So in this I have sand now. So hoppers, if I crouch now and I put 3, 4, 5, 6 hoppers, it doesn't have to be 6. Of course they're always nice to have a chest on top of them, like so. I crouched again because you cannot place. So if I have a look in this, it needs fuel. So fuel is added to this mixture. Let's see if I can move. Let's see what I can move away from here. The diamonds definitely. That. Okay, I'm happy now. Like so. Okay. So, if I put in this chest, if I put all the coal in there, this will light up, because the hoppers just transport items. So there is so many uses for this, it is unbelievable. It's an almost infinite amount of uses. So we have all our coal in here now, 16, and we are making glass. We can dye this glass to our dye color, which would be black, for instance. These ink sacs, they are black. So if I take one of the glass, and I can then make black glass. And with bone meal, if I take bones, like so. These bones, if I make bone meal in the crafting menu, I can make light gray glass, and other any color I want. So this is the bone meal, but I can make rosin red dye, and I can make all these different types of glass, and it's really fun to do that. So we'll do that later in this Minecraft Atlantis series, but for now I'm just gonna show you how to build and get to the Nether, because this is finished. For me it is finished, it might not be for you. We're gonna place some doors in here, and we're gonna place villagers on each of the sides of this box, and we're gonna dig a hole in the middle somewhere. I did some calculation where the center would be. It would be 7, I think. Here, does that look to be in the center? I cannot see, but I think this is the center of the farm. Let's do that, and I will check if that really is the center. So I had some problem with the recording device, and that's messed everything up. So if you want to make a diamond pickaxe, you're gonna need 3 diamonds and 2 sticks. Okay. I also want to tell you that my armor, I lost the helmet. So before you make a diamond armor, it's gonna cost you a lot of diamonds. We're gonna make diamond books, enchantment books to enchant the diamond, because then they will last longer. You can make an unbreaking one. So for this build, I have had three dogs, a lot of tortures, and I have had a lot of sand. In fact, I've used all the sand I got from this island I removed as well. So that's how much sand you need. I think you can get by on only this red sand, this rare sand. We're gonna see if we can make that sand in the crafting table later on, because it seems strange that it should be such an exclusive block. So I am gonna have a look here around if I can find it. But if I can't, mining this block is probably the most exclu if you want to craft the other blocks that are made from this sand, red sand, you're gonna really want a big mesa in your world, I guess. So now the next step now is to transport the villagers. I should have done that much earlier, but anyways, we'll take a lot of let's see what I can put all of this, I think, back. Yeah. So we're gonna go to the Nether, and should we do that really super fast? And in the next episode, we will yeah, we will do that. We're gonna do a super fast entry to the Nether, and in the next episode, we will try out. To build a railway all the way to this iron golem farm. Did I build that right? I guess so. Okay, so we'll place one block there and two blocks here. So this is the smallest Nether portal you can build. 10 obsidian. And you need one of these. These are found these are found in that place. So tools, and you go to the shears, which you can get wool from pigs, from the sheeps. So let's go to the Nether. What else do we need in the Nether? Cobblestone is very good to have in the Nether. What else? What else? What else? Ah, we should actually have a lot of more things, but we can go. I just checked that I have disabled my autosave, because if I only have the save on, I can always exit the game without saving. So by doing that, so we are actually next to the Nether Fortress. So that couldn't be greater, actually. Am I really on hard? There are no. We're gonna have a look. Okay, so we will quickly get this. So this is an excellent point for the gate, actually. So we'll go back. And with that, we have entered the nether and we have returned back. That was it can be much worse. That was probably the safest trip to the nether I ever made. It's almost that all the mobs were turned off somehow. I will have a look into this, what happened, because it should have been a mayhem down there. So I have a few alarms going off around me, and I must take care of that. So game on. This was a good place for the Nether portal. We are close to the Nether fortress, where we have chests with diamonds and horse armor and saddles and other things. So we will go into the Nether quite soon. Game on.